What is going on, guys? Travis Blanks here, ready to get an unboxing done for you. I've been having a busy day, guys, and this is pretty much the last thing that just popped up. And really, pretty much, it's the Marvel vs. Captain Infinity Collector's Edition. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. Travis, isn't it supposed to be garbage? And that's the thing. It's not so much the whole entire set. It's just pretty much the special so-called little boxes that they got for you. And in case some of y'all were wondering, that's the back box. But here, they got you this premium box and all that. It's not fancy and all that, but it does pretty much just tell you the gist of what's going to be in this box. And we're just going to pretty much go ahead and pop in and go ahead and open it up, because this is what I do. And the reason why I got it is because I'm just a Marvel vs. Capcom fanboy. Just like I'm a Sonic fanboy, and I got that Sonic Force pre-order. So it's pretty much virtually the same thing for me. If I can open it, jeez, Louise, this is tragic, guys. Yeah, that's all I was hearing. Like, a lot of people were saying how it's supposed to be bad and stuff. The collection is overpriced for what it is and stuff. And they failed on the thing. And yeah, you're right. They're right. They're right. And I'll give you my 2 cents about it. Come on. Oh, this box, premium box about to be messed up. There we go. All right. So, when you first open the box up, then you end up getting this. Warning, instruction manuals about everything. Pretty much just stuff telling you how fragile it is. But at the very top of it, you get the game. The premium case game, the deluxe case of the game. It is really, really thick. I kid not. Plus, you get the PlayStation 4 one, you get the exclusive Captain Marvel costume, pretty much before she ended up getting her powers as Captain Marvel. Pretty much who she used to be. But I heard that she's really OP in this game. In fact, let's go ahead and open that up. Open that up and see what's inside. So, once you take the cover off of it, you get the steel metal casing, so that it's actually pretty cool. I remember getting the one from Marvel 3. That was actually pretty awesome. Band those two together. Woo! This one here looks real good. With just Ultron up on it. When you pop it open, get the game, get the code for the character pass. Get her skin. And you get this background image of it. It's pretty awesome. But that's not all that we're here for. Once we finally open up the box, you get this weird styrofoam. I know styrofoam is the most painful thing ever. As I'm pulling it out, it's even causing me a lot of pain. But once we pull it out, you get a pretty nifty little logo on the front of the styrofoam. It makes me not want to get rid of it. It really does. It makes me not want to get rid of it. Unlike the stuff that's inside. Oh boy. See if I can pull this out without breaking anything. Alright. Little parts of it is making the pain of it. All right, first try too. We get practically everything out of it. Fight is, we'll start off with the statues first. And the first one you get is the Mega Man. Oh my goodness, Mega Man looks so epic. I don't care what anybody says, Mega Man looks epic. Oh my goodness. Smell that cheap plastic. Oh, yeah. Yep, that's some cheap plastic, guys. Don't do drugs, kids. So, you get Mega... Oh, wow. You can see the thing inside. They actually put some real good details in. So, the guys who are making the statues are Triforce, which is kind of shocking me about the unbox, but, yeah. As you can see, this is actually... It feels... you can tell it's last, but it was pretty good. I don't know why everybody said it was cheap. Like, that's weird. Like, everybody's saying that, but it actually does feel pretty good with this. That's Mega Man. We'll set him to the side. Next up is Captain Marvel. Like, oh wow, oh yeah, hey, you can actually feel by the parts on her body, like, it's not just, guys, it is not just like cheap stuff. Like, I wish they could have done a better job with her face. Her hair feels her own texture, each part of the material feels something different, guys. I'm not just saying that acting like a fanboy and trying to tell y'all this. This is actually full-blown truth. I'm being 100% honest with you with this. It's like, even the robe right here, it feels like you hear that? That's like my skin rubbing off of it. Then this is me rubbing this part. Guys, that's not cheap plastic. That's not just cheap plastic. It feels actually really good. It feels like they actually did do some work on it. And Triforce is known to be doing some great statues and stuff, which is why, like I was saying earlier, I was shocked to see what they did with the box. So I'm guessing they didn't do it. Maybe Capcom or Marvel, one of the others, worked on the box rather than Triforce, because there's no way they would approve of this after showing the box and logo and stuff on it. But we'll get into that later. Next up, we have Chun-Li, and wow, my girl Chun-Li looks real good. Why is it she looks better than the game model? That's tragic, though. I'm not even gonna kid on that. Why does she look better? Why does she look better here than she does on the thing? All right, so. The thing feels like it's like, wow. Even the bottom of her boots, the laces. Nice. Don't judge me. Kind of weird though, because it feels like it's pretty thick right here and then it's kind of skinny right there, but okay. Spikes, they feel kind of pointy. I like that. Oh my goodness, that's funny. Yep, it feels relatively good, and I like how they have it. And you can tell they put details in practically everywhere. You can see the details in the thing, the cloth, the cloth that wraps around her. There is details here, guys. If it still feels cheap to you, it still feels detailed. So I'm pretty happy about that. All right. Next up, we have Iron. Last up, we have Iron Man. Last but not least, Iron Man. Like, he was also one I wanted to check out too. Yep, it's like plastic metal, but it feels relatively good. Yeah, pretty much feel good. Like pretty much what Mega Man feels, this is what you're feeling with Iron Man. Yep. Just feeling all over the place. I'm a Philly type of guy. So statues wise, it's pretty good. Triforce did a good job with it. And this is like one of my first Triforce, because I always seen this stuff and I always wanted some of this stuff, but I can never get one of their stuff. And this is literally like my first thing I got with them. Especially when you look at the bottom of each one, they'll have Marvel, Capcom, and Triforce. Project, Triforce, Marvel 2007. Got all that right there at the bottom of the thing. Other than that, yep, everything looks good. Everything looks nice. Pretty much appreciating this and enjoying this. That's all I gotta say about that. But now we're moving to the elephant in the room. Pretty much the sole reason why a lot of people cancel their pre-orders because of this thing is this box right here. That's right. We get the batteries for it, so that's a first. That's a plus. But you get this. So, as I open it up, you get eggs. That's right. Ooh, plastic on there too. I ain't gonna be mad about that though. So yeah, from what they've shown, this is not what we get. And this is where a lot of people are complaining about it the most, because this is messed up, this is screwed up. We're gonna put the batteries in though, check it out though, but yeah. I can understand what some people's hate and frustration are for this collection. Alright, got some batteries in it now, and for the moment of truth, yeah. Pretty much, yeah, it's like it is. I like how it pulses. I like how the eggs look like they're pulsing back and forth over and over and repeatedly and stuff like that. But it's just the fact that from what they shown us that we were going to get to what we actually got, I can understand why people are mad. I can understand why people are upset about this. I can understand why some people want their money back and stuff. But, like, you know, to me, I still, my main focus really was about the whole thing, like the statues. That's my main thing, because when I went over there and saw the statues, and they said it was interchangeable, I went hype over it. So let's see about that. As you can see, they're like literally changeable. As you can see, they're literally changeable. You can match them all kinds of ways, have your own little scene of fights going on, and then lock them all into place and stuff. Oh my goodness, that's so awesome. I like how they did that. I wonder. Do it like this. Have a girl. Guys versus boys. Even though it's weird with the colors and the other colors, you can have it happen, guys. You can have it happen. Oh my. You have boom. This is why I got this, because the epicness of these statues. These statues are awesome. Yeah, that thing's underrated. But boy, does this make me smile. And that's pretty much it, guys. This is pretty much what you get. You get the game, you get the eggs, the light up eggs, you get Iron Man, Captain Marvel, Mega Man, and Chun-Li. All these here are like your main things for this box. So, who do I recommend this to? And do I recommend? My thing is, right now, no. Because one thing for a fact, I can guarantee, if this thing is still selling as badly as it is right now, it's eventually going to drop. The price is definitely going to drop, and eventually it's going to be sold cheaper, especially by GameFly, maybe Amazon, maybe eBay, anywhere over in that matter. And, pretty much, if you're a diehard fan who really wants this this badly, then I can recommend it, because you're mainly going to be wanting to get this. If you're just focusing on these guys right here, then it's worth it. If you're focusing on this, I can't recommend it. I'm being honest to y'all. I'm being real to y'all. If it's for this piece of junk, you don't need it. You don't need it. You'll be better off with the deluxe version. But if you're after these four beautiful guys right here, beautiful guys and ladies, then I can say, yeah, you can go ahead and get it then. But I'm just being real for y'all guys. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And for all my viewers out there that's waiting for me to live stream, fear not, because I'm definitely going to be trying to live stream, if not tomorrow, definitely Saturday. If not Saturday, definitely Monday. I will definitely go back and start live streaming on Monday if I don't live stream within tomorrow or Saturday. And without any other saying, guys, this is Travis Blanks signing out.